Hey everyone, it's the Outlaw John Rocha here. Thanks so much for clicking play on this reaction video for episode 9, the season finale of Agatha All Along. This is the one we've been waiting for. For those of us who've been enjoying the season, it's gotten progressively better episode by episode, certainly getting more from these characters and from these performances over the last few episodes especially. I mean, that Lily episode, episode 7, was fantastic, but this past episode I thought was really well done as well, to kind of set up everything here with a big surprising twist at the end of episode 8, which some of you probably predicted, as I said in my reaction, that it was Billy who was making all of this happen, who was creating the Witch's Road. But we do see the death of Agatha. So what does that mean? Is she really dead? Is she not dead? What's the situation with death, with Rio there as death? And did she have another trick planned for death there at the end? Agatha? So we will see. We saw Alice in the last episode as well. We didn't see Lilia in the last episode, and Jennifer got away. So what's Jennifer's role in all of this as we go into the season finale? But we also got to see glimpses of Tommy, or the body that Tommy is going to inhabit, because Billy was able to, Agatha was able to get Billy to see and reveal where he put Tommy. So that's going to be interesting. But we also saw Billy in his full Wiccan outfit, which looked good for the constructs of this show. And he drives away, just calmly gets into his car and drives away with that Eastview license plate on his car. But and then goes into the room and sees, oh, wow, you've been influenced, as I said in the last reaction episode, kind of like the usual suspects there when Chaz Palminteri realizes what Kaiser has been saying to him and that he picked it all off the walls and the stuff on the walls there. So in a way, influenced by this. So what does that mean? Like, was William influenced here? Is it Billy influencing William? What is going on? So there's a lot of questions as we go into this finale. What's the deal with Rio? What's the deal with Agatha? Will we get a Wanda appearance or a Vision appearance, a white Vision appearance, like, or gray Vision rather? What do we expect from this episode? So a lot of questions before we jump into this one. And this one is called, what is it, Mother? Here it is. It's Maiden Mother Crone. That's the name of this one. And who do we got directing this one? Let's see here. It's Gadya Montero, who is back to do this one. They did the last one and one of the episodes earlier in the season as well. So I'm going to do a 3-2-1 countdown. For those of you who are watching on my Patreon, you get the full watch along. But for everyone else, just here we go. Oh, who is this now? It looks like Agatha running down a dirt path in the woods. A little bit of a Red Riding situation. Oh, it is her. Oh, 1750. Okay. Are we going to get the full truth about what happened here with the coven and in Salem? Oh, is she pregnant? Does she have Nicholas Scratch? Is she pregnant with her son? Oh, yeah. Full on pregnant. So who impregnated her, right? That's the next question. I have, at least. Ooh, there's death.
No. No.
What's that all about? Why is she there? Oh, is she there to take her child? Oh, no.
You do this and I'll hate you forever. Huh. Please let him live.
So were they in a relationship
Please,
before?
Please.
Yeah, clearly.
I can offer only time.
How much time? How much?
Wow. Ooh. Wow. Ooh, wow. Okay.
I spoke no spell. I said no incantation. You I made from scratch.
Oh. Nicholas Scratch, that makes sense. Oh. She says, I can only offer time, you know, but all things die. So what was the offer of time? How long was the offer of time?
Sister, come forth.
Oh.
Is Ooh. The little one well?
Blessed be. We have not eaten for days.
Te acipimus in circulum.
Oh.
Has the baby a name?
Nicholas.
Join us.
Oh, is this the Salem Seven, maybe? No. Those are the sons and daughters of the ones whose power she usurped. So does she take these? Yeah, there it is. There it is. Yeah. I mean, we all feel sympathy for Agatha, but I mean, she's pretty evil. Took witches' powers, killed them. I mean, we can't ignore that just because Catherine Hahn's delivering a great performance, you know.
I think we're going to be very good at this.
Is she using a baby to get into these places? And oh. Okay, so we're getting the whole backstory, Nicholas Scratcher.
How frail you are. Surely you have kin nearby? Shall we search together?
Mm-hmm. Oh!
One can always rely on the kindness of witches.
Oh my god. Oh, wow.
Walk the road, we walk the winding road. Wherever it may bend, I'll be there at the end.
Clearly they're setting us up for some... for the kid dying in a tragic loss.
I can cast illusions. I can control a feeble mind, but I cannot heal you. I cannot protect you from what's coming.
Oh, wow. She knows he's going to die.
When she will return.
Yeah.
There it is. Down a winding road. Down the road.
So did she teach her child the samba without the witches, with witches in the place of windy? Down the road. Oh, there we go.
Down the road.
So she's essentially turning him into a vehicle for her own abilities to take power from other witches.
Where did you come upon such a curious song?
Oh.
Come, let us find you a warm meal.
I thank you, but no. My mother needs me home.
Oh, he doesn't want to participate anymore in the killing of the witches. He's pushing back. Kids do rebel.
Vicky.
This reminds me of growing up in Virginia. Used to go into fields just like this. The southern Virginia and areas of northern Virginia as well.
We can kill more witches tomorrow. I promise.
This is a whole flashback episode? Is it a final finale? Interesting.
What's gone is gone. We carry on forever
by your side.
Down the witch's road.
My blood, my tears, my bone.
This kid's doing a nice job. Acting wise. Oh, is this where he dies? Does he die in his sleep overnight? Oh, yeah, I had a feeling. Oh, man. She's come to claim him. Huh. Wow. This is some dark shit. Taking a kid's life. Okay, Disney. I mean, to be fair, that's happened in some of their older stuff. Wait, is she like Wanda? Is that what this is? Like she spends the rest of her time... I guess she's waking up to see that her son is dead and gone. Does she spend the rest of her time trying to take power so that she can bring him back to life?
No.
That's sad.
I bury my own heart here with you, my child. If one be gone, we carry on. But every mile I go, with every bend, beyond the end, our mother loves you so.
You must know the way, then.
How dare you?
Ooh.
I thought you may know the way.
Oh, who's this?
The way to what?
The witch's road.
Ooh.
You know the ballad, and I'm in great need. Might you show me the way?
Is she going to take her power, or is she going to show her the way?
We must gather a coven.
Down, down, down the road. Down the witch.
So I guess she did go down the witch's road. But did she go down to get Nicholas back? Did she actually get to the end?
Where's the door?
Oh. Oh, this is what she did last time. All right. Before. Oh, wow. All right, take it back. Maybe she hasn't gone down the road until Billy's. Oh, she's done this many times. So why? If she's doing this repeatedly, why? Oh, my God. What is this? Is this a 90s witch? So why did this time run with Billy? Why did she accept their resistance?
Are there any real witches in the house? Because all I see are has-beens.
What is that?
So she's never been down the witch's road. She's used it as a ruse and a trick to get power from the witches. This is the first time. But it is the teens' witch's road. So what does that mean? Okay, now we're back.
Boom!
Oh! What the hell?
I saw you die.
She a force ghost?
I took a calculated risk. Still figuring out the rules here, but... You actually did something interesting with your power.
You're making fun of me. This is just one of your tricks.
The ballad was the trick. It was just a con to lure other gullible witches.
Wow.
The road wasn't real until you made it real.
Oh, wow. So there's never even been a witch's road. Interesting.
If I made the road, like if I literally made the road, then that means that I...
Did you kill all those witches?
It means that I killed them.
Yeah.
I'm a murderer. Alice.
Wow. Well, I killed Alice.
Lilia, in the tower.
That was her choice.
Mrs. Davis.
Who? Don't give yourself too much credit. If you actually do the math on it, you... saved a life.
Oh! Oh, right, Jennifer. Wow. Right, Lilia said that she would go forward. She would be the one to go forward. So maybe Sashir Zamata is going to have a bigger part in the overall MCU. We will see.
I was going to kill them all in my basement on day one. If you want to be a witch, get used to this feeling.
I'll never get used to this.
We'll see.
Is he going to go back down? See if the road's there? Ooh. Okay. What's he trying to figure out here? Or is he trying to undo what he did?
You have something of mine. I know you took it. Just give me what I want and I'll be on my way.
Oh yeah, the brooch. Or the locket, whatever you want to say.
Relinque terum, naliasse fantasma.
What does that mean?
Vade ad lucem. Relinque terum, naliasse fantasma.
What are you doing?
I'm banishing.
Oh, it's the banishing spell. Ooh.
Time to go toward the light or into Rio's toxic embrace. Or wherever you deserve to spend
Wow.
eternity. I really don't care anymore. Vade ad lucem. Relinque terum.
Wow.
You can't do this. 5 seconds ago, you all bent out of shape about killing witches.
You're already dead. Vade ad lucem.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
Why won't you just die?
Because I can't face him.
Ooh. Who is him? Is that her son?
Nicholas.
Yeah. Ooh, interesting. Desperation.
I'm sure he would forgive you for whatever you did.
Huh. It's when you say things like that. That you remind me of him.
Ah, yep, there it is. It makes all the sense in the world. Complex character. She's clearly murdered a lot of witches, but she is a humanity to her, for lack of a better term.
We can make a good team.
Coven 2.
I do tend to kill my coven members.
So do I.
Oh, yeah, good point. Wow. Yeah. Oh, he destroyed the witch's rope. Oh, man. Nice. Keep a bit of a headstone.
One door closes and another opens.
Whoa!
Let's go find Tommy.
Ho ho! There you go. A bit of a subdued finale for sure. One that allows us to see the backstory between Agatha and her son Nicholas, which I thought was really sweet and touching and moving, but didn't spare you from the fact that Agatha, as obviously as I said now a number of times throughout this reaction, she is a killer. She kills other witches indiscriminately for their power. She needs to feed. It's what she does. And you can say all you want, like, oh, you know, she can't help herself. She's compulsive, blah, 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 blah. All these things that people were saying before. Oh, she's an addict. No, this is all planned out. This is premeditated. So you kind of have to come up with your own feelings about Agatha and the fact that she does this kind of stuff, because her losing a child, her, you know, falling in love with Tommy and Billy as kind of a replacement for her child, it doesn't necessarily excuse all the terrible things she's done, because how many people has she left childless, you know? And so this is these fascinating conversations we need to have with ourselves when we look at a character like this. You know, same thing's happening with the Penguin. So a lot of people are on Team Sophia, a lot of people are on Team Oswald, but either team, they're both criminals, and there are a number of dead bodies in their wake. So, but you know, you got to balance things out. So with Sophia, you have what happened to her from her at her father's hands, and then with Oswald, you have her, his mother, to kind of humanize him and his relationship with Victor, which is a massive part of it. So here, you know, Billy, in a way, kind of whitewashes or cleans Agatha a little bit, because we like Billy so much. But Billy, clearly, as you saw here in The Witch's Road, and as he admitted in the show, killed these three witches, or killed these two witches and this woman in Sharon Davis there. So he has a propensity to kill as well. So this is an interesting situation we're walking into. Does life and death not mean the same thing as it would for a human approach to it? Is life and death in the magical world a little bit more fluid, shall we say? Overall, I thought this was a fantastic series. I really enjoyed the performances. Very much enjoyed what we got here in this finale, as a kind of a coming down from what with a massive ending of episode 8. And now, is Agatha really dead? Is she a spirit in the spirit realm as a guide? Is this a way of keeping Agatha in this whole equation without Wanda, but without having Agatha actually physically there? So she's a ghost. So what does that allow them to do magic-wise here in the MCU going forward? It's a lot of questions. And what role is Jennifer going to play in all this? Because the way she flew away looked very similar to some other heroes we've seen before, both live-action and in the comics. So got a lot of questions there of what Jennifer might turn into. What are your guesses? Let me know down in the comment section below. But I thought overall this was a fantastic series. Certainly got better as the show went along, and having these episodes, these last two, be what, 49 and 41 minutes, so we could really savor how they landed this plane, I thought was really cool. So great acting, really fantastic direction here throughout. And now we've got questions going into the MCU and seeing how all of this will connect up down the road. We shall see as we go along. All right, well, what do y'all think? Let me know what you thought about this episode down in the comment section below. Did it work for you? Did it not work for you? What stood out to you? What didn't work for you? Let me know all of it down in the comment section below. And give me your ideas of where you think this is leading to. What's your speculation here going into the larger MCU? And will we get a season 2 of Agatha All Along here going to find Tommy? So let me know what you thought about it all down there in the comment section below. I'd really appreciate it. And shout out to all the fantastic actors here: Catherine Hahn, Joe Locke, Ali Yan, Sashir Zamata, Deborah Jobrat, Patty LuPone, and Aubrey Plaza, of course, who, we only saw her in a couple of scenes in this episode. So clearly her last episode was the really big episode for her, and I appreciated that. So let me know what you thought about it, all of it, down in the comment section below. Remember to subscribe to the channel and hit that bell button. And if you want to watch my full reaction, it'll be up on the Patreon for the $5 and above level as well. All right, thanks so much for joining me, and I'll talk to you next time. Well, thanks for joining me for all of these reaction videos we've done for Agatha All Along. And also, don't forget, our spoiler review is up now if you haven't caught it yet. Our spoiler review of the Geek Buddies for these two episodes is up now that you can take a look at as well. All right, take care of yourselves, be well, and I'll talk to you next time with another brand new reaction video here on the Outlaw Nation. Thanks so much for watching this video. Please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more content from the Outlaw Nation.